More Filipino families consider themselves as poor. A survey conducted by the Social Weather Station survey shows 48%, or around 13.2 million Filipinos, rated themselves poor as of September. This is higher than the June figure of 12.5 million Filipinos. The survey also shows Mindanao fared the worst in self-rated poverty. The survey was conducted from September 28th to October 1st. After two straight months of acceleration, the Philippine Central Bank expects inflation to ease slightly in October. The Consumer Price Index is seen to settle within the range of 5.1 to 5.9% on the back of lower prices of oil and key agriculture commodities. Meanwhile, the uptick in electricity prices and transportation costs may have contributed to the upward pressure for this month. Philippine inflation accelerated for a second month in September to 6.1%. The BSP delivered an off-cycle rate hike last week in a bid to help tame a stubborn inflation. Credit card spending seen to remain elevated despite the high interest rate environment. This outlook from Credit Card Association of the Philippines, which cites the 39% growth in card spending in the first half of this year. The group notes, even after the Philippine Central Bank raised its key policy rate to its highest level since 2008, the public remained undeterred from using credit cards.
The interest rates are still high. In fact, we expect it to remain high maybe till the end of the year. But, you know, this is not really affecting card spending so much, mainly because majority of credit card holders are actually transactors. Mm-hmm. These are individuals who pay their bills in full every month, so they don't have to pay interest. Mm-hmm. Aside from that, most of the transactors are actually the big spenders. They're the ones with the big credit lines. We expect that the spending will continue, especially the high inflation rate. You know, people are using credit cards to extend their purchasing power. So they're turning to credit cards now for their everyday needs. So we think this will continue.
The Philippine travel industry continuing its recovery from the pandemic. The Immigration Bureau has recorded over 30,000 daily arrivals and departures in the country's airports since the start of the long holiday break. It is confident the travel sector will soon surpass its pre-pandemic record of 50,000 daily passengers. The BI also noting the situation at airports remains smooth and manageable despite the influx of passengers.
There have been a lot of travelers these past few days. I think we're almost reaching pre-pandemic figures. We're really happy about this because it really says that things are going back to normal after the pandemic. It's more work for us, but it's work that we have prepared for. So far, what the feedback that we've been receiving is that the passenger queue was manageable, it was tolerable, it wasn't so long as expected.
And time now for a check on the traffic situation at the North Luzon Expressway this All Saints Day. Jack Batalionas now joins us for that. Jack, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, we are currently stationed at the NLEX Balintawak Toll Plaza to provide real-time traffic updates. As of now, traffic is light in RFID lanes, but there are some delays in cash lanes due to the ongoing RFID sticker installations for vehicles without RFIDs. The NLEX management aims to implement a 100% RFID system by next year, making RFIDs mandatory for all vehicles passing through. NLEX has deployed 1,500 personnel for enhanced patrol and toll plaza assistance, running from October 27 to November 6. They are actively managing traffic, assisting vehicles at gas stations, and offering free towing for Class 1 vehicles during specific times. Expect heavier traffic southbound on November 5 through Monday morning, November 6, with an anticipated 10% increase in traffic. To avoid congestion, motorists should plan their trips during non-peak hours. Additionally, Carmina, the Metro Manila Development Authority has temporarily suspended the number coding scheme on October 30 and November 1 and 2.
We're going to go over now to the Manila Memorial Park, where Jervis Manahan is standing by with an update. Jervis, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, the weather is pretty bad here at the Manila Memorial Park in Paganaque, but the rain is not stopping visitors from flocking to the cemetery. As of 11 a.m., 33,000 visitors have entered the Memorial Park. Flow of traffic is moderate to heavy inside the cemetery as it is open for vehicles. There are parking spaces allotted inside, but they are on a first-come, first-served basis. Park management said more than 102,000 visitors were recorded yesterday, and a lot of them stayed overnight at the Memorial Park. They are expecting more than 200,000 visitors today, but the number may change because of the inclement weather. Some Salesian nuns visited the tombs of the departed members of the Aquino family. President Bongbong Marcos also sent white flowers for the Aquinos today. No untoward incident has been recorded so far, and there are very few prohibited items confiscated at the gates. Phone signal is relatively weak because of the volume of people inside. A locator booth is also set up for those who might get lost. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Jervis Manan, there joining us live. Well, Cebuanos also flocking to cemeteries in the province to visit their dead. Annie Pedestal joins us with the latest from there. Annie, over to you.
Yes, Carmina, we're here in one of the largest cemeteries in Cebu City, Careta Public Cemetery. And so far, authorities say that everything is peaceful and in order. However, there are still those who are making last-minute cleaning and beautification based on the guidelines released by the cemetery and the Philippine National Police. This shouldn't be allowed. They're only giving them until 3 p.m. to complete everything, the cleaning and everything that has to be done to the tombs. Earlier, the director of the Cebu City Police Office, Colonel Ireneo Dalugdog, made his rounds to conduct assessments in the cemeteries. Except for a few senior citizens that fainted and illegal vendors that were able to get in but then were escorted out, he says that their security plan is going as expected. The crowd isn't as much as it was last year, the Dalugdog spokesperson, Police Lieutenant Colonel Janet Rafter says. It could possibly be due to the long weekend where the crowd is already dispersed over the past days. People continue to flock the cemetery at this time, and the authorities have not logged also any untoward incident and confiscated only minor sharp items. As of 12 noon, there is no crowd estimate yet for all 21 cemeteries of Cebu City. But here in Careta alone, we were told that some 1,500 to 2,000 individuals already came to visit their departed loved ones. In this cemetery, there are about 15,000 individuals buried here, including those who suffered during the ill-fated MV Princess of the Stars years back ago. And the authorities said they will continue to monitor all 21 cemeteries in Cebu, including 13 cemeteries located in the mountain barangays of this city. And that's the latest here from Cebu, Annie Perez, ABS-CBN.
Well, millions of Filipinos are paying their dearly departed a visit in cemeteries across the country this All Saints Day. President Marcos visited his father, the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr., at the Libingan ng Mga Bayani. Katrina Domingo now joins us with that story. Kat, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and his family spent All Saints Day at the Libingan ng Mga Bayani in Taguig City, where the remains of their patriarch lay rest since 2016. Aside from the president, among those who attended the mass in honor of the Marcos patriarch, Ferdinand Marcos Sr., are First Lady Liza Marcos and their sons, Simon and Vincent, as well as Marcos family matriarch and former First Lady Imelda Marcos. And the president's sisters were also there, particularly Senator Aimee Marcos and Irene Marcos Araneta. The president did not grant interviews after the mass at the Hero Cemetery, but in his official Undas message this year, the president reminded the public that these holidays are meant to honor the dead, and they also come as a refreshing gift so that we can enjoy reuniting with our loved ones while also receiving much-needed nourishment for our spiritual lives. The president also reminded the public to reflect on the purpose and our unceasing need for God's guidance during the holidays that celebrate the saints' staunch devotion and the legacies of those who have gone before us. Now, meantime, Carmina, Vice President Sara Duterte also released her own All Saints Day message, telling the public that the All Saints Day and the All Souls Day holidays are opportunities for the nation to reflect on their faith and ask the Almighty for the continued blessing of strength and healing as a nation. She also asked the public to pray for the country's protection against calamities, disasters, wars, and forces that may threaten our unity and cause human suffering.
President Marcos gets into the Halloween spirit and shares ghost stories of his own. He recalls some spooky experiences he had growing up in Malacañang. The president and several palace staff shared their eerie anecdotes in a vlog.
Dito sa tinatawag na reception hall, nung una kaming dumating dito sa palasyo, at balitang balita na kung minsan sa gabi ay may dumadating na ginigising sila, na ang tawag nila si Father Brown. Nung tinignan namin ang kasaysayan dito sa palasyo, meron daw talagang Father Brown na Amerikano na dati, nung panahon ng Amerikano, ay nandito nagtatrabaho. At ngayon, mukhang hindi na umalis dito sa palasyo. Yung formal na hagdan na papasok sa palasyo, actually ilang beses nangyari sa akin, pag akyat ko na ganun, ramdam ko na may nakatingin sa akin dun sa likod. Atras tuloy ako paakyat dahil nakakatakot.
Well, Filipino mythology and folklore took center stage at a Halloween ball at the National Museum of Anthropology in Manila. A look at the spooky and star-studded event from Gretchen Fulido.
Filipino mythology and folklore characters, the Diwata or fairy, Sirena or mermaid, Valentina, and other Pinoy pop culture icons were the theme for Shake, Rattle, and Ball, a one-of-a-kind Halloween party held at the National Museum of Anthropology in the city of Manila. Senior high star Andrea Brillantes was unrecognizable in her ghoulish costume made out of wipes and latex.
Your inspiration for this amazing Halloween costume?
Mix na lang ako. My dad is a manananggal. My mom, siya yung Encanto. Tapos ako, parang rebel child ako. Tapos strict parents ako. Tapos na-in-love ako. Tapos nasawi ako kasi pinili niya yung tao. Imbes yung dapat kakainin ko, na-in-love ako sa kanya.
Other celebrities said they took time to research for their costumes and it took them many hours to achieve their Halloween looks.
My inspiration is the Sirena. Actually made my ears a few days ago out of resin.
San Telmo. In English, St. Elmo. Bolang apoy siya. Isa siyang dead person na naghahanap siya ng justice.
Today, I am the queen herself, Venus Ra. Major.
Among the best costume awardees are singer Jason D, Colleen Garcia, and artist Micheline Sihuko.
San Telmo, parang fire cryptid, and also a little bit of Doja Cat.
It's actually inspired by Ibong Adarna, so hence the wings.
I did everything from scratch. This is my baby, and it's a combination of the Tiana and Anak ni Zuma.
Famous love team Don Bell, Donnie Pangilinan, and Belle Mariano came as their favorite Pinoy superheroes.
You came as Captain Barbell.
She came as the one and only Darna.
Sakaling ma-offer ka ng Darna.
Are you na.
Oh my God! I don't know, yeah? Who would say no? Sino yung mag-no sa Darna, diba?
The Shake, Rattle, and Ball Halloween Party is the official kickoff to Alamat, a special exhibition of the contemporary works of renowned Filipino artists at the National Museum of Anthropology. The art exhibit opens today and will run until December and is free admission for the general public. Gretchen Fulido, ABS-CBN News.